imagine you're a user, you're watching a video on the internet, YouTube or Netflix, and you get frustrated because the video takes too long to load, or the quality is too low, you actually can't see the content, or it stops and stalls and buffers every once in a while. This is a real problem. It affects users, and it causes significant problems for content providers. Like 1 second of buffering leads to millions of dollars of lost revenue. What we need is some mechanism that can adapt the quality of the video, the resolution, and so on, as the network changes dynamically.
So when video gets downloaded from the internet, it gets placed into a playback buffer. Consider this playback buffer to be a bucket. Consider video to be water. The video downloaded from the internet fills up the bucket. The video that is played on to the screen is like a hole in the bottom of the bucket that consumes water. Traditionally, there were two approaches. One is called buffer-based, and what it does, it looks at the quantity of water there is in the bucket, so the amount of video that you have stored, and based on that, then it requests the next chunk of video. The second approach is called rate-based. If we still use our analogy, you can see a bandwidth as the pipe that fills up this bucket. So the rate-based algorithm looks exclusively at this pipe. So if it perceives high bandwidth or sees a very large pipe, it will request high quality video. If the pipe is small, then it will only request lower quality video. So we used a control theoretic approach where we modeled the problem mathematically, and we used both pieces of information to design our algorithm, and we can prove that in the average, we get better performance.
Okay, now we are comparing our algorithm with buffer-based algorithm, which is proposed by people in Netflix. You can see the video on the right is really blurry comparing to the video on the left. And we can see that our algorithm quickly converts to the highest possible bitrate, like 2000 kbps, versus the buffer-based, which is still at 600 kbps. And the buffer-based algorithm needs to accumulate buffer step by step and ramp up to the highest possible bitrate very slowly.
Our goal is really to improve internet video in the broader world. And we're doing this in a couple of different ways. One is we're actually open sourcing the algorithms we've developed, which is built on top of the industry reference player, and releasing it as an open source platform for future researchers and so on. It also in talks with many leading industry players in this space to get our ideas out there into their production systems to help improve users' experience.